gone all the way over to Fushan. But you're talking about we go through denial, we go through anger, but now it's basically a comedy of errors. While we were collecting these samples to LSU, we actually got permission from the Corps of Engineers, their Incident Command Center. We go out to Freemason Island, and when we get there, the United States Wildlife and Fisheries comes, basically pulls their boat up, opens an arm, and we give them all our LSU credentials and so forth. And you know, next thing we're expecting to be arrested and trying to come up with a remedy for this thing. We've since then come up with a remedy, and trying to get BP or anybody to listen to us is, you know, just isn't happening.
You know, this thing just, the situation just changes every day, and I guess, you know, who's running the show? The Coast Guard's supposed to be, you know, pushing the oil company, and the oil company's sitting on their hands, and the governor's out there, he's saying that, hell, I'll go to jail with the mayors, Grand Isle, and whoever else, and this whole thing is, and will they ever be able to clean it up? But what's your confidence about cleaning up what's in there already? It might be futile. Really, it might be impossible. We don't know to remove that stuff. I appreciate your call. How do you respond? People just don't trust your oil company anymore.
Well, all of us at BP are trying to solve the problem. Those words are hurt a little bit because we've been open about what we're doing. What we're doing is certainly not anything in secret. We've had direct oversight and involvement from government agencies from the very first hours afterwards. There is an imprecision around the measurement of that crude oil, which I've used the analogy that it is a little bit like popping a soda can, rushing out with lots of gas and oil. There's a lot of gas in this crude. The rate is unclear. We're measuring and producing some of that today. But in terms of not trusting BP, I mean, there's nobody who is more devastated by what has happened, and nobody that wants to shut this off more than we do and learn what happened so this never happens anywhere to anyone, anywhere in the world again.
So the BP managing director went on to say now they're going to try to top kill Wednesday because they need daylight for this particular operation. All right, let's go to Billy Nungesser this morning here on WWL. If you found daylight to start your dredging project, good morning, Billy Bob.
Don't good morning. How you doing this morning?
We're doing everything we can, you know, like you, to help.
Well, we had a great meeting yesterday with the governor and the other parish presidents and leaders from across the coast, and today we're looking at what areas to pump up, or what areas would we need to start at that would give us the best benefit of keeping these waves of oil out. We've lost some battles, but we can't lose this war. If you saw the Pelicans, where we were out at Cat Island yesterday and see the eggs covered with oil, the baby chicks, you know, and then you take the oiled mom away, you know, and those eggs don't hatch. It's just heartbreaking.
Yeah, they're actually stained with oil. They had the pictures of some of the eggs that were in the nest in the plankton. Now, why do we need any professional, or excuse me, why do we need any federal permission? Can't we just go out and start pumping?
And that's what we discussed in meeting in Venice yesterday with all the leaders. You know, we're each taking our parish and, you know, where we can make the quickest impact to keep these waves of oil out. And you know, I'm going to ask our council to fund some money to get started. You know, the horrible thing about it, the Coast Guard would step up to the plate and be a real leader here. They could have demanded it happen immediately. There was a way, you know, they could demand BP pay for it, you know, and then the Corps issued the permits. And this thing, a lot of it would have been in place and avoided a lot of the problems we went through all weekend with oil back in the marshes. We've got to put our heads together, put the... But we also, the dredge companies, to pay weekly. We've got to put the funds in place. Dredges to stay out there and get this work done. So,
you need BP to cut you that check now. They got to pay for it.
Yeah, well, they're not going to do that. You know, they had the chance to step up to the plate and miserably failed. You know, all the talk with the president came and met with me, and just like the Coast Guard, I got every excuse or why they can't, they shouldn't do it. Well, we told them they would regret it, and before this is over, there's going to be a lot of people regretting that they didn't stand up to the plate.
So now how are you going to pay these people if they start dredging? Who's going to come up with the money?
Well, the governor's going to put some funds together. They're working on it. I'm going to ask our local parish for $1 million to get started. We're looking at marsh buggies. We're looking at anything we can do to bring these berms back up above the... you know, in Redfish, there's a sandbar out there. It was out the water years ago. Brought that back up out the water. Miles and miles of Roseau canes that are now submersible. We could have picked up that sandbar.
I'll tell you what, Billy, you're breaking up so bad. I want to take a break here. Can you just call us right back real quick?
This is
important. I got some scientists over the weekend, did a story on it. There's actually risks being too aggressive trying to clean up because we could ruin the marshes and do more harm than good. I want to get a response on something like that from you. All right. There's some people coming up with some risky things to do about getting the oil out of the marsh. There's some people talking about setting fire or flooding it out, floating out the oil. Have you heard any of that talk?
I heard a lot of different things. You know, once it gets in there to the nesting grounds and all that area, I don't think anybody could even consider setting these islands where all these birds and everything's breeding on fire.
That sounds crazy.
You know, the areas that it's gotten into and very well saturated in there at Passalucha, Redfish Bay, Cat Island, and it's going to continue to come in. You know, we've boomed a lot of those areas off.
How many miles right now, the worst scenario is that oil inland?
Well, the governor said 67 plus miles of coastal area, but inland, it's several miles inland. You know, it's worked its way through those, lots of Roseau cane land. There's water in there that's worked its way into those backwaters. We've blocked off a lot of the main canals, and protected some of the areas, but it's just so massive. You know, it's intertwined.
We're going to run out of time, Billy. I know. Keep the pressure on BP to use some of the equipment boats they got out there. They haven't even used them. It's sitting.
We need some leaders.
All right, sir. Good luck to you. Praying
Thank
for you.
You.
Thanks, Billy.